When working with Hibernate, you can choose between multiple APIs to query data from your database. Some of them are very flexible and provide almost unlimited options to filter and transform your query results. Others are specifically designed to implement specific tasks as easily and quickly as possible. Hi, I'm Torben Janssen. In this video, I will show you 6 different query mechanisms supported by Hibernate. 3 of them are flexible and 3 are specialized for a specific use case. If you are using a different JPA implementation, you should at least learn about the 3 flexible and the 1st specialized options. These are defined by the JPA specification and supported by every compliant implementation. But before we start, if you are new here and you want to learn how to create your entity mappings with ease, build incredible efficient persistence layers with Hibernate and Spring and all types of other Java persistence related stuff, subscribe and click the bell to get new videos every week. And also don't forget to like this video if you found it helpful. By doing so, you are helping me to reach more people with it. For most use cases, you will use one of the following flexible query mechanisms, which I will show you in the next few minutes. They enable you to define a query using the projection and filter criteria that suits your use case the best. Let's check them out one by one. Let's begin with the most popular one, JPQL. JPQL is JPA's query language. It is very similar to SQL. Its main difference is that you specify your query based on your domain model. The following code snippet shows a simple example that selects all book entities with the provided phrase in their title. When you execute this query, your persistence provider, for example Hibernate, generates an SQL query, sets the bind parameter values, and executes it. While generating the SQL statement, Hibernate adjusts it to the dialect supported by your database. That makes your JPA query database independent, but it also limits you to the features supported by your persistence provider. You can do a lot more with JPQL. For example, you can choose different projections in the select clause, create join clauses over multiple tables, order and group the query result, and call database functions. I explain all of that in great detail in my guide to JPQL, which you will find in the description below. The Criteria API is a set of interfaces and classes that you can use to specify a query. It supports the same feature set as JPQL. The following code snippet defines the same query as the example in the JPQL section. As you can see, using the Criteria API requires more code than a JPQL query. But it is much easier to adjust based on user input and easier to refactor. When you execute this query, Hibernate generates the same query as for the previously shown JPQL query. You now might ask yourself why or when you should use the Criteria API if you could do the same with a JPQL query. The Criteria API provides 2 main benefits. Number 1, you can define your query dynamically at runtime, and number 2, if you combine it with JPA's meta model, your query definition gets type-safe and easy to refactor. If none of these theoretical benefits provide you real value for your specific use case, you should use a JPQL query. Otherwise, I recommend my advanced Hibernate online training, in which we discuss the Criteria API in great detail. Hibernate executes native queries directly. It doesn't need to generate the SQL statement. Due to this, you can use all query features supported by your database, and you are not limited by Hibernate. That makes native queries more powerful than JPQL queries and the Criteria API. But that also requires you to create a native query statement that matches your database's SQL dialect. If you deploy your application using different RDBMS, this might require different versions of the same query. The following code snippet defines a native SQL query that selects all columns of all records in the book table in which the title field contains the word Hibernate. By providing the book class reference as the 2nd parameter to the query, I tell Hibernate to cast each record in the result set to a book entity object. If you want to learn more about this flexible and powerful approach to define your queries, you should take a closer look at my video Native Queries, How to Call Native SQL Queries with JPA and Hibernate. You can also provide the name of a SQL result set mapping as the 2nd parameter. It tells Hibernate to map the query result to scalar values, entity objects, DTO objects, and any combination of these 3. I have a series about result set mappings. I will put a link to all of them in the description below. JPA and Hibernate also define a few APIs for special purposes. These are not as flexible as the ones we discussed in the previous section, but they make the implementation of some common use cases incredibly simple. The find method on JPA's Entity Manager interface is a typical example of an API specifically designed for one use case. The only thing you can do with it is to load one entity object by its primary key value. This is a common task in every persistence layer, and the find method makes that as easy as possible. As you've seen in the previous code snippet, you only need to call the find method with references to the entity's class and the primary key value. Hibernate then generates the required SQL statement to select all columns mapped by the entity class of the record with the provided primary key. This approach also works in the same way if your primary key consists of multiple attributes. This is called a composite primary key, and I explained the required mapping in a previous article. And Hibernate, of course, also handles inheritance mappings that map an entity class to multiple database tables. In addition to the find method defined by the entity manager, Hibernate's session interface also provides a by multiple IDs method. As you might have guessed from its name, this method enables you to fetch multiple records by their primary key values. When you call the multi-load method, Hibernate generates an SQL statement with an in clause to load all objects with one query. This might only look like a small usability feature, but as I've shown in a previous article in my blog, Hibernate automatically splits this operation into multiple batches if you load more records than your DBMS supports parameters in an in clause. You can also decide if Hibernate shall exclude primary key references to entity objects that are already part of the first level cache. Another common use case is to load an entity by its natural ID. Using plain JPA, you need to write a query for it. Hibernate provides an annotation to declare the natural ID attributes and an API to fetch an entity by its natural ID. Let's use that in an example. You first need to annotate one or more entity attributes with @naturalID. After you've done that, you can use the byNaturalID method defined by Hibernate session interface to get an instance of the naturalID load access interface. On that object, you can then call the using method for each part of the naturalID. After you've provided all ID components, you can execute the query by calling the load method. Hibernate then generates a query to get the primary key value for the provided natural ID. In the next step, it fetches the entity by the retrieved primary key. To improve this approach's performance, Hibernate caches the mapping between the natural and the primary key and tries to resolve the entity reference against all activated caches. You can learn more about these optimizations, the handling of composite natural IDs, and the caching of mutable natural IDs in my guide to Hibernate's natural ID support. You should check it out from the description below. As you've seen in this video, Hibernate supports the three different options defined by the JPA specification to define a query. All three of them are flexible and enable you to filter the retrieved data by complex predicates, select information from multiple database tables, and transform it into the form that best suits your use case. In addition to these three options, Hibernate also provides three APIs that were designed to fetch one entity by its primary key, multiple entities by their primary keys, and one entity by its natural ID. These APIs are not as flexible as the queries, but they make their supported operations as easy as possible. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free member library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like a cheat sheet for this video, and an ebook about using native queries with JPA and Hibernate. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. And if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!